Boys, taking the fight to superheroes on Amazon Prime Video on July 26th.
That show looks so good.
From the studio that's gone from doom and gloom to fins and grins comes a fun-filled ride for the kid inside everyone. Just maybe not actual kids.
Kill the little girl.
Shazam! Meet Billy Batson. He's got the street smarts of Bart Simpson and the streetwear of Tyrone Biggums. When Billy gets lured into a cave by an old man who claims to be a wizard, which, to be clear, kids, is never a good idea.
Lay your hands on my staff.
He'll become one of DC's classic characters, Captain Marvel. No, he used to be Captain Marvel, but DC changed it to Shazam. That's Kazam. Common mistake. I mean the guy obsessed with being worthy and lightning. No, the street rat who gets wish fulfillment powers.
Wish fulfillment?
3 wishes to be exact.
Okay. It's the one where Chuck flosses. Gather round for a heartwarming tale that outfamilies Fast and the Furious.
I'm a big believer in finding family.
You know, me time can also be construed as pushing away his family.
If a superhero can't save his family, he's not much of a hero.
Thank you for this, family.
You don't turn your back on them.
During a change of pace from Marvel's constant daddy issues, we get another installment of DC's Sad Mom Parade.
Forgive me for everything.
If you choose to leave, you may never return.
I'm sorry I never told you. I felt shame.
To me. That was not a really good time.
That moment got your boys for real.
As Billy learns that family isn't about who abandoned you at a carnival on a whim. It's about the people you're forced to live with, who love you because you're constantly saving their asses from being killed.
Come on.
But Shazam will have to fight more than just the overburdened foster care system. He's up against Dr. Sivana, a veteran character actor out for revenge on DC for casting him as Sinestro in Green Lantern. Watch him unleash the power of the seven deadly sins, each its own representation of a different human failing with unique powers that... Actually, no, never mind. They're all just kind of gray blobs who just eat people. Man, The Rock cannot get here fast enough. Does the next one really have to be about the very angry caterpillar?
The seven realms are about to be ours.
Follow-up question? What? So cheer along as DC finally cracks the code on making a heartwarming, fun, inspiring movie about an invincible strongman, a Superman, if you will, that gives kids everything they dream of. No, not turning into a 38-year-old in a styrofoam muscle suit. No, not terrorizing the bullies who make your life a living hell. I'm talking about a kid's ultimate power fantasy. Developing a moderate YouTube following.
Ooh.
Doing it for the memes, baby! Smash that like button! Shazam! Starring, you're a wizard, Billy. The movie trying to write the starring section for us.
Thunder Crack!
Captain Sparkle Fingers.
Power Boy
Maximum. Voltage, is it?
Mr. Philadelphia! Human Power Storm, Frequency Flinger, Sir Zapsalot.
Yeah, not so easy, is it, kid? Chief of Staff. See, now that's how it's done. He is a villain. He came here to steal an eyeball from a wizard. Bird Ward of the State. Preteen Titans Go. An uncomfortable amount of R. Kelly references.
Believe that you can fly.
I believe I can fly.
Make a live-action Gargoyles movie, you cowards. Can we become a flossing now, please? And...
Please.
Through the window, through the wall. It's always sparky in Philadelphia. Okay, this is the second DC film with an Annabelle cameo, so The Conjuring definitely takes place in this universe. Quit teasing us with the cameos already, and let Aquaman punch the nun in the face!
This I did not even know that. Boys, wow. Series, I'm all for Annabelle vs. Batman. Take my money if that ever happens.
Your friendly neighborhood Night Monkey.
Night Monkey.
No more Mr. Knife Guy. The week is long. The silver cat feeds when blue meets yellow in the west.
My boys, I loved Shazam. I thought Shazam was a cool new concept for the DCEU. I think that's gonna be their two. They have three namesakes, I think, right now in DCU. It's gonna be Wonder Woman, Aquaman, Shazam, and then Batman eventually at some point down the line. If it is connected to the DCEU, I have my doubts that we will see that Robert Pattinson Batman connected to the larger part of the DCEU when the movie is eventually done. I just don't think DC is really focused on team building anymore. You know, I don't think they're trying to focus on doing this again because that was horrendous. And I think they're more focused on these solo films and building these solo, you know, trilogies than they are doing these whole build-ups and shared universe. I think they will, like, tease certain elements from other DC movies, but I don't think we'll ever see another Justice League movie for a long time. I still have my doubts that we'll get the Flash movie. It's been how many years since we've been hearing about this Flash movie that continues to get canceled, continues to go through directors every single year. It's one of the most cursed movies out there right now. I highly doubt we ever get that Flash movie. We're not getting that Cyborg movie. We're probably not getting another Man of Steel, which is unfortunate. It just, DC is in a weird place right now, and especially with them skipping Comic-Con, you know, every time I think that they're finally riding the ship, something happens and then they take like three steps back after they just took two steps forward. Look, I'm excited for Wonder Woman 2. That movie looks phenomenal. Aquaman 2 looks like it's going to be great. It brings back James Wan. Any movie with James Wan attached is going to be great, and it's gonna make a shit ton of money. Shazam 2, I know Shazam didn't make all that much money, didn't destroy the box office, but that was expected. It was in the middle of Captain Marvel and Avengers Endgame, and no really movie has been making a lot of money, honestly, other than Endgame, Aladdin, and Captain Marvel. Those are the three movies that made the most money, and it's weird because I really thought this was gonna be a great year for Warner Brothers. You know, Detective Pikachu, great, didn't make that much money. Godzilla, great, didn't make that much money. Shazam, pretty good, did not make that much money, and it's kind of weird that these movies are, it feels like Endgame literally ended the box office completely, and we'll see how Lion King does this weekend. But like, a lot of these movies other than Aladdin after Endgame, a lot of these movies have been bombing when it comes to making significant money in the box office. I think Shazam was good. I really do hope we get the second one. I do think we are going to get the second one, because eventually at some point I do want to see Shazam versus Black Adam. I don't know how I feel about a solo Black Adam film with The Rock. I'd rather just see him in the movie with Shazam. We'll see how that goes. I have heard the rumors, and the rumors I have heard of certain cameos, it does sound like the Black Adam movie will be well done. But eventually, I do hope we get to the point where we get Shazam versus Black Adam. And I hope the second Shazam does better in the box office than the first one. Because even though the first one did better and it doubled its budget, it wasn't groundbreaking. Like, Aquaman made $1 billion. This one didn't even come close. It was still a good movie. But again, when you come out in the middle of two big movies like Captain Marvel and Endgame, two big MCU properties, of course there's gonna be some sort of, not a loser, but somebody was gonna not make the money that they thought they were gonna make. But again, Shazam wasn't that big of a budget, so they were able to live off of that. I do hope they get the second one done. I do hope we get a third one, and I hope we do eventually get Black Adam versus Shazam. To me, that would be iconic and dope. I do eventually do want to see The Rock Black Adam happen. But again, with a lot of these DC movies, my boys, they say a lot of things, and you get really excited for these DC movies, and then they never happen. They kind of just go away. You know, we've been waiting for The Flash forever. I think Birds of Prey, I've heard amazing things about Birds of Prey. I think that movie is going to be amazing. I've heard amazing things about Black Mask and the characters in that movie and the script and the way they filmed it. I am really excited. With all the movies that are coming out, other than Robert Pattinson as Batman, which I am all for, I like that casting choice, other than Wonder Woman, Aquaman 2, for whatever reason, isn't coming out to like 2022 or 2021, so that's years away. One movie that I'm definitely excited for, other than that's in the DCEU, I don't count Joaquin Phoenix's Joker because that is a separate DC property that has nothing to do with the comics or anything like that. But one of the DC movies that I'm looking forward to the most coming soon is definitely Birds of Prey, just because of the things that I have heard off of this movie, the rumors that I have heard. I know some other YouTubers have decided to spoil the movie on Twitter, and that's unfortunate, but you know, she's got to do what she's got to do to get those clicks and those views. I mean, I just wish that she wouldn't have spoiled it. And if you guys know what I'm talking about, you guys know what I'm talking about. There are certain things that have already been spoiled about Birds of Prey, but from the things I have heard and read and heard from other reliable sources, Birds of Prey sounds freaking amazing, and I cannot wait to see it. That is probably one of the most anticipated DCEU movies that I am looking forward to the most. Other than that, we don't have another DC movie other than the Joker, and again, this year, I mean, other than the Joker, but the Joker isn't connected to the DCU. That's its own separate property. So the next DCEU movie we get isn't until June of 2020, and that is Wonder Woman. It really does seem like after Shazam, that DCEU is just going to take a break for the rest of the year. I hope the Joker does well in the box office. I think Joaquin Phoenix is going to definitely be up there for a... He's going to have one hell of a movie there. I mean, that movie looks iconic. But again, I'm excited to see what's next for the future of the DCEU. I think they're on a little bit of a roll because I think Aquaman was amazing. Of course, they made a shit ton of money. Shazam was fun and reminded me a lot of Kick-Ass. And now we see what is next for the DCEU moving forward. We're not going to get any news this upcoming weekend because, I mean, they are just... absolutely nowhere to be found at San Diego Comic-Con this weekend. But we will see what is next for the DCEU. This is a great video. Link down below for the original video without my shitty reaction. And if you like this video, slap that thumb, subscribe, and join the Hollywood Quick for daily uploads Monday through Sunday, 7 days a week. Links are all down below in the description. Comment down below, what is your all-time favorite DCEU movie? My boys, it's a double upload day, so I will see you guys in a bit. You guys enjoy the rest of your day. Too sweet.